Hello students, welcome to MJC Learning. Today we are going to continue our chapter Solutions of Chemistry. This is part 4 of this chapter. Earlier we have discussed about what is colligative properties. What are the different 4 types of colligative properties? First is vapor pressure lowering, boiling point elevation, freezing point depression and osmotic pressure. And out of these 4, we have already completed vapor pressure lowering. Now let us see the next one, which is boiling point elevation. So let's begin. In this video, we are going to dealing with these following points. First is boiling point elevation. We will discuss about what is boiling point elevation. Boiling point elevation and concentration of solute. What are the relationship between boiling point elevation and concentration of the solute? Molar mass of a solute from boiling point elevation. How we can find molar mass of a solute from boiling point elevation? So first is boiling point elevation. Let us first understand what is boiling point. We already know that vapor pressure of a liquid is directly proportional to the temperature. Means when the temperature increases, the vapor pressure of liquid also increases. Liquid boils at the temperature at which its vapor pressure is equal to the applied pressure if the container is closed. For the liquid in open container, the applied force is atmospheric pressure. So let's define what is boiling point. So it is defined as the temperature at which the vapor pressure of liquid becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure. Boiling point is a characteristic property of a liquid and is used to check the purity of the liquid. Boiling point increases with increase in external pressure. Liquid having greater intermolecular forces have higher boiling point. We have learned that vapor pressure of a pure solvent is more as compared to the solution with non-volatile solute. So pure solvent requires less heat for its vapor pressure to reach equal to the atmospheric pressure. And as vapor pressure of solution is less, it is required more heat so that its vapor pressure will equal to the atmospheric pressure. So at the temperature of boiling point of a pure solvent, solution will not boil, as its vapor pressure is less than that of the vapor pressure of a pure solvent. Hence, the boiling point of a solution is always higher than that of the boiling point of a pure solvent in which solution is prepared. Now, if TB naught is the boiling point of a pure solvent and TB is the boiling point of a solution, then we have already discussed that boiling point of a pure solvent is lower than that of the boiling point of a solution. So delta TB is greater than delta TB naught, means this is the boiling point of a solution is greater than the boiling point of a solvent. So elevation of boiling point, which is denoted by delta TB, is given as TB minus TB naught, means boiling point of a solution minus boiling point of a pure solvent. Similar to lowering of vapor pressure, the elevation of boiling point also depends on the number of solute molecules rather than their nature. So it is also a colligative property like vapor pressure of lowering. Boiling point elevation as a consequence of vapor pressure lowering. Let us compare boiling point elevation with vapor pressure lowering. Boiling point elevation is directly proportional to vapor pressure lowering. Why? We already know that vapor pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. Hence, vapor pressure elevation is directly proportional to vapor pressure lowering. The vapor pressure of a solution and pure solvent are plotted as a function of temperature in this graph. Now, as we see, on this axis, vapor pressure increases and on axis the temperature is increases. At any temperature, the vapor pressure of solution is lower than that of the vapor pressure of a solvent. Why? Because at a particular temperature, the vapor pressure of solvent is more as compared to the vapor pressure of solution. So the curve of solvent is always above the curve of solution. Okay, now next, as the temperature increases, the vapor pressure also increases. Hence, for a solvent, if temperature increases, then the vapor pressure also increases. Similarly, for a solution, as temperature increases, the vapor pressure of solution will also increase. As the temperature increases, vapor pressure also increases, and when it's reached to the this value, means 760 mm, which is equal to atmospheric pressure, then the boiling point of the solvent is TB naught and the boiling point of a solution is TB. And when we join these two, we will get the exact temperature at which the vapor pressure of a solvent is equal to the atmospheric pressure and vapor pressure of a solution is equal to atmospheric pressure. So when we plot an intersect on this line, we will get boiling point of a solution and boiling point of a solvent. Now the difference between these two, means boiling point of a solvent and solution, means that this line A and C will give us the elevation in boiling point. So difference between these two is give elevation in boiling point, which is delta T is TB is equal to TB minus TB naught. So temperature is increases, it is clearly seen that boiling point of a solution is greater than the boiling point of a solvent. So the intersection of the curve CD, this CD, with the line of corresponding atmospheric pressure is the boiling point of a solution. Similarly, this is the boiling point of a solvent. So we can conclude that the boiling point of a solution, that is TB, is higher than that of the boiling point of a solvent. Now, boiling point elevation and concentration of solution. Let us see what are the relation between boiling point elevation and concentration of solute, that is molality. As we dealing with the system in which the temperature is not constant, we are dealing with the boiling point, means temperature is not constant. So we cannot express concentration of solution in molarity because it changes with the temperature. Whereas molality is a temperature independent. So we use molality, not molarity, small m. Okay. So experimentally, we have shown that for a dilute solution, the elevation of boiling point, that is delta TB, is directly proportional to molar concentration of solute, that is M. So elevation of boiling point in dilute solution is directly proportional to molality, that is small m. Thus delta TB is directly proportional to molality. We can write as delta TB is equals to KBM. What is KB? It is a proportionality constant. So the term molality, M denotes the number of moles of a solute present in 1000 gram or 1 kg of a solvent. Proportionality constant KB is called as boiling point elevation constant or molal elevation constant, or also called as ebullioscopic constant. If molality is equal to 1, then delta TB is equal to kb. Here if the value of molality is 1, then this will be equal to this. So we can define the molal elevation constant as kb is defined as the elevation of boiling point produced when 1 mole of a solute is dissolved in 1 kg of a solvent. The units of molal elevation constant, that is kb, is Kelvin kg per mole. Molar mass of solute from boiling point elevation. Let us compare molar mass of solute and boiling point of elevation and how we can find molar mass of solute from the boiling point elevation. So we know that delta TB is equal to KBM. Earlier we have discussed about it. Let's take it is as equation 1. So if W2 gram of a solute of molar mass M2 is dissolved in W1 gram of a solvent, then we know that molality is defined as number of moles of a solute in mass of a solvent in kg. Okay. So what is number of moles of a solute? Weight of a solute divided by molar mass of a solute. So moles of a solute can be written as weight of a solute divided by molar mass of a solute. And in 1 gram of a solvent, it is dissolved in 1 gram of a solvent, W1 gram. But we want solvent in kg. So we will convert W1 grams of solvent in kg, which is equal to W1 divided by 1000 kg. Okay. So now, if we put all these value, then molality M of the solution is given by the expression M is equals to number of moles of solute, means weight of solute divided by molar mass of solute. And mass of a solvent in kg, which is converted in kg, which is equal to W1 divided by 1000 kg. So by rewriting this equation, we will get this M2 will go down and this 1000 will come up. So 1000 into W2 divided by M2 into W1 mole per kg. So substituting the value of molality in the equation 1, what is our equation 1? Delta TB is equals to KB into molality, small m. So value of molality we will substitute in the equation 1, we will get delta TB is equals to KB into 1000 into W2 divided by M2 into W1. Hence we have to find the molar mass of solute. This m will go this side, so M2 is equal to KB, this delta TB is here, into 1000 into W2 divided by delta TB into W1. Thus, in order to determine the M2 or molar mass of solute, the known mass of a solute, the known mass of a solute in a known mass of a solvent is taken, and delta TB is determined experimentally for a known solvent whose KB is also known. Then we can find the molar mass of a solute. Now let us solve some problems related to this. So problem number 1 is the normal boiling point of ethyl acetate is 77.06 degrees Celsius. Means the boiling point of solvent is 77.06. A solution of 50 grams of a non-volatile solute in 150 gram of ethyl acetate boils at 84.27 degrees Celsius. It is the boiling point of solution. 50 gram is for solute and 150 gram is the solvent. Evaluate the molar mass of solute if value of KB is also given, that is 2.77 degrees Celsius. So let's solve this. So this is the formula for molar mass of a solute. M2 is equals to 1000 KB into W2 divided by delta TB into W1. So let's write down what are given. W2 means weight of a solute 50 grams. Weight of a solvent is 150 grams of ethyl acetate. Delta TB means TB is boiling point of a solution minus boiling point of a solvent. So boiling point of solution minus boiling point of a solvent, which is equal to 7.21 degrees Celsius. Here, temperature we will be dealing with in Kelvin only. So there are two ways. First, we will first convert this degree Celsius in Kelvin, then do the minus. But here, this is 7.21 is the difference between these degree Celsius. It is also equal to 7.21 Kelvin. Why? Because the magnitude of 1 Kelvin is equal to the magnitude of 1 degree Celsius. Means the difference between 2 degree Celsius value is always equal to the difference between 2 same Kelvin value. Means if we convert this degree Celsius in the Kelvin and then when we minus, we will get the same value. If you not believe, then please solve this. Okay. By converting this degree Celsius into Kelvin, you will get 7.21 Kelvin. Now, value of KB is 2.77 degrees Celsius. It is equal to 2.77 Kelvin. Same, the magnitude of degree Celsius is equal to the magnitude of Kelvin. Means, if the difference between the degree Celsius is 100, means if water freezing point is water is 0 degree Celsius and its boiling point is 100 degree Celsius. So there is a difference of 100 degree Celsius. Similarly, the boiling point of water in Kelvin and the freezing point of water in Kelvin, there is a difference between these two is 100 Kelvin. So the magnitude will be the same. If you are not comfortable with this, we can convert this degree Celsius into the Kelvin first, then do the calculation. Now, substituting these in the above equation, we will get 1000 as it is KB. Value of KB is 2.77, W2 is 50 gram. Delta TB is 7.21 Kelvin and W1 is 150. When we solve all this, we will get 128 grams per mole. Now let's see the one more problem, which is 3.795 grams of sulfur is dissolved in 100 grams of carbon disulfide. Means sulfur is the solute which is dissolved in carbon disulfide solvent. This solution boils at 319.81 Kelvin. Here it is already given in Kelvin. So no need to convert this. What is the molecular formula for sulfur in the solution? When we dissolve sulfur in carbon disulfide, what will be the molecular formula for sulfur? The boiling point of solvent is 319.45 Kelvin. So let's solve. We have also given KB value for solvent, which is 2.42 Kelvin, and atomic mass for sulfur for calculating molecular formula. So solution first, this is the formula: M2 1000 into KB and W2 delta TB into W1. So these are the given value. Weight of solvent 100 grams, weight of solute 3.795 grams, delta TB means boiling point of a solution minus boiling point of a pure solvent, which is equal to 0.36 Kelvin. Substituting these above value in the equation, we will get 1000 KB. KB is 2.42 and weight of solute is 3.795 divided by delta TB is 0.36 Kelvin into 100. When we multiply this all and by dividing this, we will get 255.10 grams per mole. So we have to find the molecular formula for sulfur. So number of atom in a molecules of sulfur is molar mass of sulfur divided by atomic mass of sulfur. So first, molar mass we have already calculated. So it is 255.1 and divided by atomic mass, which is given here, is 32. So we will get 7.92, which is nearly equal to 8. So number of atom in the molecule of sulfur is 8. So the molecular formula would be S8 in this carbon disulfide. Thank you.